of two grown-up adults who are able to make an informed decision that they want to go into that adventure. If one person don't want it, you don't even have to go into it. No means no. You know what I mean? Then for this particular couple right now, it's possible there are some certain things the woman wants from the man, and the man is not fulfilling, that needs. And what could those things be? And getting to go in that route is connected to our emotions. How you feel. If you are happy, you're going to have a good one. If it's not, if you are not happy, you cannot have a good, intimate time with your partner.
Sure,
Then,
sure.
now you can, your woman can be angry. You must have hurt her.
Excessive, I see you.
I greet the house. I greet everyone.
Yeah, hi. You must have hurt her, right? And now, for the fact that she move around, she do as if things are okay, or she make food, go to work, and all of that, it doesn't mean she's happy. You understand? So if she's not happy, having sex will be the last thing she will want to think in her memory. You understand?
Whoa.
Based on where we came from, it is like the man ego. They feel when they get married to you, they own you, they bought you, and they paid for it. So whether as a woman, whether you want sex or not, whether you're in the mood or not, if the man wants it, you have to give it anyway. You know what I mean?
Sure.
And that is not supposed to be so. It's supposed to be partnership, good understanding. As okay, she's not just feeling it right now. Let me not go there. This very man now, it could be wrong. It could be possible that any time she approached the wife, the timing is wrong. She don't know when the wife wants to rest. She don't know when the wife, actually wants that. You know what I mean? And so, but the fact that he wants it right there and then, if he's not giving, he will be offended. He will, that's where the war starve comes in. So what am I trying to say? That man, my advice will be this. Number one, find out if you have wronged your wife or not. It could be intentional or not intentional, but find out. If it happens that you have wronged her in any of those ways, make peace with her. Then that says another aspect will come, after that. Number two, sex is psychological. You understand? And so when you have a very good sex, you can just be driving, the thought will come into your heart, into your mind. You think it through, you do the role play, the way everything went down. Or romantically, you can find yourself being in the mood. You will be hard.
Romantically.
You understand? So, no, that is how it works. No, no, to be honest, then if you have a horrible sex, the sight of it grows you out. You understand me? You could even be surprised. Subconsciously, you will not even have a taste for it. Don't want to even have it again. So that is why you say, they say people, they cheat. People cheat, not because they don't love their wife or something like that. It's possible before they met their wife or during courtship, they had a very good sex with an ex, and that ex know how to take them to the land of Eldorado, east and west and all of that. Then,
Eldorado.
no, no, yeah, you know, no, it's possible that is it, okay? And that person that
Yeah.
knows how to take him to the land of Eldorado and everything, he thinks he's not a wife material, and that based
Okay,
on the way.
Don, let me bring you home. Thank you for all that. Do you have a story related to this that you want to share with us
Yeah,
before
what
I
else?
talk to Excessive?
Okay, so yeah, so let me try to round up everything off right now. So what I'm going to say regarding this relationship, this very particular topic is this. Number one, the woman should find out if she has wronged the wife one way or the other or not. Number two, find out the sexual needs of your wife, of the woman. Every woman, they have different, what they call it G-spot or something. Where they want to be touched, the way they want to be touched. Now, it's natural,
Nice,
okay?
I see you.
Man tend to get to an orgasm faster than women. You understand? And so, depending on the woman's physiological makeup, you have to understand your man, your woman. How does she want to be touched? Some people they like to clean plate or head or whatever. So people like if you play with their nipples, whatever it is. Find out that spot that will put that your wife in that mood. That's number two. And so number three, you might also want to find out if this woman, a woman will be say, he likes to maybe long sex or short quality sex. So how can you push her close to that orgasm first? Is by foreplay. Do a complete foreplay. You know, no matter how urgent it is for you to just insert whatever, a jet or whatever, no. Slow it down, take your time, master her body, play with her body and get her in that mood. Every other thing will follow. You understand? It's not supposed to be something that has to be, you have to scratch your head before you tell your woman or tell your mommy on her own shows. You understand? If it is sweet, everybody will want that. When you guys agree, you have a sweet and beautiful sex. To be nervous when he's when it comes to that point, you know, to of asking his partner for sex. Uh-huh. So now, when you just suppose that scene, probably this man married this woman because the woman is reserved. You know, she doesn't wear all those revealing stuff and all of that. So women can be very, very pretty because they were so you know, from the culture where they were brought up, they might not be wild. The way Mr. A, as a man, we think.
True.
It's possible that my woman, you know, like her sexual drive is low. And so it's possible, like, she's not used to doing it as often as the man wants it.
Thank you.
Okay.
You understand what I mean? And so for the fact that she's not doing it as often, the man will be upset. It's possible maybe whenever the man take one little shot or whatever, the man is turned on all the time. So this it's possible this woman that this man married is like those Christian holy type that doesn't like to drink a lot of liquor and it doesn't even easily get in the mood of having sex every time. So you're going to have that challenge. So my advice to this man should try to understand the need of the wife. How can you do that? Let them sit down. Sit down, make a very casual environment whereby you talk. If you want to even talk about the topic, don't even start with the topic. Use what they call sandwich method. Talk about every other people, maybe her friends or your friends, whatever, from there. Narrow it down to the particular situation, you know? We haven't had
sex. So you start with other things, then you narrow it down to this issue, then you end also with other things because sandwich is like, you put it in you the understand? Center.
Yeah.
So 600 years for you.
Yes. When you make that, when you use that approach, you know what I mean? Why am I saying that? When you use that approach, you will make her more loosen up, more free, more open. You understand? So most of the time, when you call a woman, say, okay, come on, Mrs. This, sit down there. We have to talk, or I have to talk with you. Automatically, it's psychological. Automatically, she will want to pose an attack. If it's a woman that is very defensive, you understand? And so once you see that down like that, it's okay. You see, you didn't put salt in soup yesterday, whatever. I have to go by myself to put salt. And so in her mind, the way you even, because once you tell her to sit down, she will be tense and she will be waiting for you to come across. When you come across with a negative statement, you have messed up the whole conversation. You understand? So when you start from something X, that's something she will even know, different topic, then in a method, bring it back to your current situation and experience. Then tell her, oh, if you were to change anything in me, in terms of maybe sexual encounter, that intimate moment, what would you like to change in me? That will make me drive you gaga, whatever. Then she will talk. Oh, I like for you to first take me to dinner. I like for you to, you know, light a candle. I like to, she will tell you. First of all, you cannot fix what you don't know. The problem. You understand? Correct. You can't fix. Okay? Then now you have to, number one, ask now, what is it that I'm doing wrong? What is it that you will expect me to do more? Then she will not tell you. She will narrow it down. Make sure when she put it, that if you have to write, if you have somebody who will forget, write them down. You understand? Write them down and make that deliberate effort to work on those issues that she has pointed out. Waiting women like hate pass, eh? Waiting women hate pass. If they tell you, say, I don't like this, I don't like this, I don't like this.
Call the dorm again.
You call the dorm again. Or later, you go ask them again the same question, maybe another one month. Hey, how you say you think they want this? They piss them off. You understand? And so you don't want to do that. Make a deliberate effort to fix it. Once you don't tell you, then after those certain things. And now, marriage is not easy. says, you know, even easy, it can be boring if you're not being innovative for inside.
That's what I was going to say. Boring, you thank you. I was going to bring it up.
You understand?
Yeah. You too much.
No, not be lie. Not be lie.
I love the experience. I love it.
So, and not be lie. So,
don't go on.
So, also, you also have a therapy. That one, option B. Option A starts from you. You are the chief therapy. When you first try fix and by yourself, troubleshooter, find out, ask those questions I've asked. When you're able to face it, you will be good. Sometimes there's what they call like aromatherapy. Some of them they made them with like a CBD extract or whatever. You understand? So there are different things you can use to spice up your relationship.
You mean like and massage? You mean the massage?
Like massage.
Put some nice music. Yeah, candles around.
You understand? You know?
You're getting the story. Like
yes.
Make your wife some dinner or something.
Yes. You know
she's
what
coming
means?
Back from work. You know, mm-hmm. she's tired. Mm-hmm. You don't want her to come back mm-hmm. and start making food. You want to make a dinner, put a candle at dinner, help her, run the bar. Great. Bubble bar.
You know
bar,
what I mean? Yeah, bubble bar.
I can't go that
way. You understand? No, for real.
So for real.
Listen, man. Blind person, if the food is sweet, blind person, they know, you don't need to see her. You don't even know the color, but it will taste like it will make sense. So why I talked about aromatherapy, like what she said, like now, you can buy like some oil, right? Easy to massage her after a long stress of the day, you understand? You massage her. If she's
lavender oil, lavender oil, peppermint
lavender
oil.
Oil. Yes. It puts you... Yeah. It puts
in the
you
mood.
In a different mood. You understand? Or like humans, like pheromones. Like there's a way you will create that ambient, that environment that will make her, you know, fall for you. You understand? And so I'm just saying. And so now there are some a candle you will also light. Those candle, right? The aroma, the it's like vaporizer. It changes the ideas
fragrance.
Of the environment. It helps you relax. You know, some of
them
you can
fragrance.
Pray. Yes, you understand? So when you take all those things into consideration, do what she loves. Then for if you do that, then she will not develop even like a different level of love with you. There are some people, they get married, they don't really court for so long. They don't really love each other to that level, to go that distance in life. But because they felt like it was the right thing to do at that time, they did it. They make that decision. But that doesn't mean the love is at the apex. You understand? So those little things, those little actions, how you open the door, you help, you know, with dishes sometimes, you just cook randomly. Those things has a way of triggering a different kind of bond. And mind you, if your woman truly loves you, even if she not wants it, she will want to make you happy.
Boom.
You understand?
Boom.
No
boom.
Matter what. And she will want to make you happy. So this man have to find out, this woman, what is actually wrong? Is what is wrong with the woman, or is my expectation of what I expect this woman to be doing, or the way I want her, how often I want her to be having sex with me? You understand? It's possible the problem is not even the woman, is the man. Because our expectation is what stretches us out. It's what creates panic and worries and assumptions. You understand? And so if that woman now, they like this man every day. This man will call, if you be a friend, will say, hey, my brother, I know the way till I go marry you. He bless you if I work for, you understand? And so they don't marry. So in order for him not to be scratching his head to do that, let him develop all those things, those step by step. Then when it comes to that, you don't even need to say it. The way you touch her, the way you know, all the way down, automatically she will understand the language. You understand? And when she gets that language, you build up from there. Then make sure you get her close as possible to her orgasm state before you say, okay, take it away. You understand? Because if you guys don't go along, it happens, say you can't quit come, if she never come, you don't put her for that mood, you can't mess up everything. There is nothing way for you to marriage like that. You understand? You will for just let her be where she did. If you know, say, you know, if he make her reach that orgasm. So that is why you have to do all the
four. That's why men who cannot have a satisfying performance, you are coming quick. Send me a DM. Send me a DM. send me a DM. I'm not the customer for nothing. Send me a DM. Let's help your life.
Yeah.
Talk about 4 hours. We are there. Yeah. Hmm. You don't even go.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, send us a DM. Let's help you.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So you can keep looking younger. But I'm a virgin. Don't go on.
Yeah. So like I was saying, make sure if you see somebody that takes longer, and also women's body are different. Okay. There's a physiological makeup of a woman, you know, down there. Some of them are extremely sensitive. Some of them are, you know, less sensitive. Some of them, that as a result of their past experience, they could be raped, they could be post-traumatic, or it could be maybe circumcision, it could be, you know what I'm saying? You don't know. And so, but when you understand this woman, you have to know what kind of person is this. How you take touch some kind of part for them when you sing and say, I want to, or whatever. So once you understand her that to that level, it will be easy, even for her, for you to ask her, and even for her to ask you, for sex, if she wants it, so make her live and for death, like for the now, so the other
continue.
John,
you don't say it's kind of the whole place. Continue.
Let me tell you, I know 21 forever is true, but let me tell you something,
right?
If not that you are a married man, I would have given you my sister for free. I said, don't pay that.
Uh-oh.
I'm telling you, you are such a
wonderful man. You want a second wife?
No, I'm a Christian. My woman will even kill me before I think.
See, John. I gave you a simple assignment, and you took it to every corner. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
If I shut down here, I've gotten enough. Thank you, sir.
It's too much. Too much.
In fact, I'll tell my team, we are following you and liking all your posts. Like, we love you.
Thank you.
It's too much.
Thank you. Thank you.
God bless
you
very much.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Love everyone. Thank you.
God bless you.
So much love to you.
So when they were dating, like in school, because she dresses sexily, he was thinking she's, you know, in bed. She'll be this. Yes, but she doesn't have a high libido. She just, you know, loves dressing sexily, but she's not sexual. Do you get what I'm saying? Meanwhile, he has a very high libido. That, the way life is, that is actually how it works.
That's maybe fake life.
No, she just dresses...
No. Like, go on with this story.
You know, the story is too close to comfort, but you know, but in all honesty, that's one of the, you know, the beginning of the story, but I don't want to go any further because the story is too sweet. But I can't say much because it's too close for comfort. But I have another one as well, where again, the wife is very lovey-lovey, touchy-touchy, but she's not sexual at all. Mm. Once a month is good enough for her.
This person should go back to comment session.
Do you understand where I'm coming from? Once a month is happy. She's happy for once a month. Do you get what? It happens a lot, but she's touching. When you see her touching, holding hands with him, all over the person, you think she's sexual, but she's not. Apparently, she's not sexual. She just likes it once a month, or she's not really sexual at all, but likes to hold and touch. And some people are like that. While the man might be highly sexual, but remember
it's
that
so, everything. How are you?
But remember that everything about relationships is not only about sex. There are other. Other qualities that are there that I won't say would override sex, but you know, are also good enough. She might make a very good mother, you know, she works very hard.
Yeah,
she might be the sole breadwinner as well, like the doctor. Do you get what I'm saying? There are so many different points about life. Sex, yes, is a part of it, but that's not the only thing. And maybe when they do make love, they enjoy their sex, but it could only be once in a while. Do you get what I'm saying? And if he has a high libido, I don't know what he will do to sort himself out, but it is what it is. But not everybody has the same sex drive. That is the reality of life. You know, and there's still, to me, much more in a relationship than only sex. So, Oga, just try and be happy. Talk to your wife. See what you can do to, you know, you cannot probably make her as sexual as you are. But all I can say is that if you have a little child, help her out. Look after her as well, pamper her, because women, we want to hear good things. If you dress well, you want to hear, oh, you look beautiful. Mm. You want to hear, you know, we are very emotional. We want affection. Mm. We want that care and love. It's true.
Right.
Remember, when they were dating, maybe they were even having more sex. Maybe you were looking after her and giving her the attention. Yes. When you get married, there are a lot of things. Everybody takes each other for granted. And that is the reality. So that sex might not be as hot as maybe when you were dating. And, you know, living together, of course, is a different kettle of fish. Where you're seeing each other every day. It's more or less like see finish.
True.
It's not extra special as when you were... Yes, it's not extra special as when you were dating. You dress up for him to see him and you're thinking of, I just want to have him tonight. You get what I'm saying? That's the truth.
Yes.
So,
Mare Unorodo, one of the reasons my first marriage collapsed like London Bridge.
Eric Moore.
That's deep.
It's deep, but there's so much to marriage anyway than only sex. Because some people will even quarrel, will have great sex, but they don't even like each other. Do you get what I'm saying?
Very true.
Do you understand? The both of them could even have high libido. I spoke to one of my friends, she's complaining about her husband maybe cheating or doing other things, for example, or even beating her or whatever the case may be, for example. Yes? This is real life, I'm saying, but I don't want to really go into it. But
why do people change routine after marriage?
But she tells me that when they quarrel, that is even when that is very good in bed. I say, are you serious? She said, yes. When they quarrel, she doesn't mind sleeping with him. I say, are you serious? People are different.
Make us sex.
Yes.
It's different. Yeah.
It's different. Yeah. But because he's very good in bed, you just still, I'm like, are you kidding? But you don't really like him. You don't even want to be married to him in the first place, but the sex is still good. So it just goes to show.
I will be back. Your question is because we are human. It's a natural thing. It's
that?
Just normal. It's not. There's no relationship that stays at the same pace forever. No.
Exactly.
You understand? But the most important thing is, what do you do when your relationship goes down? You understand? What are the things you do to spice it up, to wake it up again? You know? It's just like the question this gentleman is asking us now about his wife and him, you know? See, they said the problem identified is a problem half solved.
Correct.
Mm-hmm. You understand? Because so many men will be in this same situation and they will keep quiet. At the end of the day, when everything is all over and the wife and the daughter is gone, they start saying, if I had known, I would have asked for help.
Yeah.
You understand? Very true.
Yes. See, a lot of us, we go through so many things that it is, thank God for social media. Thank God for social media. See, a lot of people will not understand. In as much as social media has done so much damage in our generation, but yeah, social media has also done a lot of good.
A lot of good.
I agree.
A lot of good things. Social media, yes. See, social media is what you want social media to be for you.
True.
If you want social media to be a place of comfort, then you will know the kind of friends you follow. I don't know if you saw my post last week. I had to unfollow almost about 64 people.
Whoa. Because,
yeah, last week, Sunday. 64, like I was just unfollowing. Because I realized I was with my kids that weekend. And my son was like playing game and his head was like next to my shoulder, you know. And my little daughter was here. So the two of them can literally see me holding my phone. You understand?
Yes.
Dr. Precious, you not believe. When I went on Instagram, every page I was going like this. Nyash, nakedness. Nyash, nakedness. Every time I saw myself like hiding my phone from my kids. I'm
yes.
Like, who be all these people? I just put a post there. But after like 2 hours, I started deleting people. Block, block, block. Instagram can, social media can be what you want social media to be for you. Select your friends. Some people are toxic. Some people are there for you to. When you become their friends, see, anytime you see them, you derive a thing of joy. That's why I always tell people to be mindful of the phone calls you pick in the morning. Can easily make your day or ruin your day.
True.
Mm. You understand? And
you are responsible for your timeline.
Yes. You have to be very, very careful because there are some people that don't know how to start conversation. I'm not your friend. I don't know how you got my number. You call me, all of a sudden, just start. I'm like, calm down. Okay. Hello, good morning. How are you? A lot of us, we don't get manners.
You know,
so we have to be very careful. It is good when people say you are difficult, because you are polishing your space. You understand? Because whatever you tolerate, it dominates you. When you tolerate people that are toxic, before you know what is happening, you become toxic as yourself.
Sure.
There's nothing wrong in eliminating friends. See, the smaller the circle.
For a man, physically, you're turned down. For a woman, it's different.
Sure.
We want to hear sweet words. We want to be, you know, if we feel loved and cared for. For us to even want to even go close to you. You understand? That is actually how it works. So I think there are a lot of factors in this matter. And, you know, he's not happy. What have you said to your wife? What has she said about it? You know, you're just saying you're not happy. It's just a physical thing. You're not happy. Is she happy? Do you understand? Is she happy with you? Why would she want to starve you? So I don't know what other people want to say. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
More interesting. Yes.
Yes. It helps us to learn more. But he has given us the wisdom. SBC, there's something nobody talked about, which Eric said. If you listen to him, I wrote it down. He said, put family out of your situation if you want to solve the problem.
I totally agree
with
that.
The one thing that ruined, you know, my previous...
It ruins many families, SBC. A lot of families are down because this one will call his mother. Your mother will never support the husband. Your mother will support you. The man's father will support the man. Your mother will support you as a woman.
One of the greatest mistakes of, you know, this situation was, you know, when I went to tell the mom, because it got to a point I needed to cut the attention of the mother. The advice she gave me was like, my son, even me too, 19, you know, it was one of the reasons me and my husband had issues when we got married. But guess what? He has to adjust. So she wants me to adjust. And I know he adjust because me, I dey like Mark.
Yes.
So instead of going to the daughter to say, my daughter, you have to start with, you know, but because I should adjust. How do you want me to adjust? I married at the age of 26, a 26 years old boy, I should adjust. Where my body still the heart. It's not possible.
It's not, my brother. The mother was not hearing what you were saying.
At 26, you were very young though. 26 was very young for a man. To me, oh,
26 that have arrived. I had everything I ever wanted.
Yes. What are you waiting for? At 26, you have everything. What are you waiting for?
Yes.
What you say?
I said that's. First time I'm saying this. I think I got married at 24.
Yes.
I got married. Are you serious? I got married to my ex at 24. We were like this childhood, a white girl, childhood high school team that lasted us like 20 years together.
Really?
Yeah. We just broke up like 2 years ago. Yeah.
You're up to 40.
Who, me?
Yeah.
He's above 40.
I'm still a small boy. Don't allow all these dress and all these tattoos, all these things to deceive you.
No. I don't think he's more than 33, 34.
No,
don't do that. My son is my first son is 13. The truth is this, eh? It's all about you. I go to the gym like 4 times a week.
Wow. Yes. I need to start. I need to start because if I start.
Mama, it's okay. You said that 16 last year. You said you need to start last year.
No, after coming from this holiday, I'm starting. Look at how fat I am. Hey, God. No. I need to show my bikini body at 55, I beg. What's that?
Yeah.
No, but you're perfect. Not, if it no, was I'm if not. It was your type, we talked about in the Secret of Wednesday, even people like us will not mind. You remember that secret? The 54 and 54.
No, somebody like me for no mind now.
Mind. Eric, in and out.
Even, you see,
One name.
Dr. P.
In the inner outer.
We're not going to talk again. Mommy,
don't
worry. We're not going to talk again. I tell my mommy, don't worry.
These are the athlete.
SBC, are you still there?
I'm here.
Back. Okay. He's back.
Yeah,
you were saying something.
I had a patient today. The guy from Mauritius. So I was like, "Oh, Mauritius is so beautiful." This is my patient, too. And he said to me, "Mauritius is as beautiful as you." I said, "Thank you very much." Then he now says, "I work with 99% of my people. I work with."
Eric,
sorry.
Thank you for coming, bro. Thank you. We love you. Okay? We love you. Now, I feel you. I know what it means to have a heart like this. I see through your heart from
me
your
too.
Eyes.
I can see it.
And I want you to know that we are always here for you. We are all brothers.
Of course. We are
we
family,
love
bro.
You.
We are
play like this, but we love ourselves.
Yeah.
We stay in touch. We're a family. There's nothing I go through now that I can't call SBC or call 21 Forever. I'm telling you, we're bond. We love you, okay? Stick with
God
us.
Bless
you.
Sometimes
when people share some things, they have experience.
He's saying something. I can't hear him.
No, I said I just followed you guys on IG right now. Okay, thank you.
Okay,
I'm going to follow
your Eric. What are you, Eric? What's your own Eric?
Oh, Eric Moore. Okay, I see. Just click on that secret diary. You'll see my list. Then
I followed you. Yes. God bless you.
Okay.
You're a wonderful person. Love to your mama or your sexy mama.
Okay. Bye. Bye, Eric.
That was so sweet. I could see. I think it was touching. It was close.